thirsty.
All right, so first of all, how do I...
I mean, I could read it now. So I was like, yeah, sure, whatever.
Yeah, we need to go with the square of this one only. Mm-hmm. If I factor the 9, I have a square minus 2x, and it leaves some space, plus 24y squared equals 27. So what do I add here?
1 squared.
So if I add, I'm adding a 9, so I'm adding a 9 to this, this side. So therefore, this is 9 times x minus
1
plus 24y squared equals...
Two down, and then book. Like, holy shit, what'd you write?
Everything by 36. And I get x minus 1 squared over 4.
Four.
Plus
two-thirds.
Two-thirds y squared equals 1. But that's not the standard form. Remember, the standard form, there is no coefficient in the numerator, only in the denominator. So you rewrite it as x minus 1 squared over 4. Plus y squared over
3 over 2.
So this is
the
equation of the a's. Okay. So given that, what is a, what is b, and what is c?
A is 2.
A square root, this is the bigger number, so square root of 4, which is 2. B would be
square root of 3 over 2.
Yeah, approximately whatever. And then c would be four minus 3 halves, which is 5 over 2, yeah.
That's all I fucked up.
Okay, that's it, that's all the
page. Oh,
so what is
one.
The center?
I just put 4 minus
3.
One, zero. So there's a shift of 1 for every x. Okay? The vertices would have been plus or minus 2, 0.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to shift by 1. So 1 plus or minus 2, 0. We'll give you 2 vertices. The first one would be, 1 plus 2 here, and here 1 minus 2. And this one would be
3, 0,
and the other one,
-3, 0,
yeah. For the foci, I'll have 1, because there is a shift of 1, plus root 5 over 2, 0, and the second one would be 1 minus root 5 over 2, 0.
I did it by 2. So that when I did it, when I subtracted
right
it, instead of it being 8 minus 3, it was 4 minus 3.
Right here.
So my bow guy are all
the other one is right here. Vertex 2.
I thought it would be 4 minus 3.
You can figure out where to turn here, so
but then I should
still
get
that's the value
of
the bow
guys.
You can approximate this value, square root of 3 over 2, 0 point something. And that's, you go see a value, that value here, and that value here. And that's how you know where you can reach the maximum point.
You should give me a line.
I'll take, hopefully I.
So this is the B value here, B and minus D from the center. And you get your A's.
And when we're writing these